partying here in Jolly Harbour, and we've suddenly got something to celebrate. This is Budget Marine, and this is 30 years of Budget Marine in Antigua and Barbuda. And I'm joined by Robbie Ferron, the founder of Budget Marine and the powerhouse behind the management of the shops. Of course, Louisa, good afternoon to both of you.
Good afternoon to you.
Now, this is really exciting. This is 30 years, and Budget Marine is Antigua and Barbuda's biggest supplier of almost everything you need if you're on a boat.
I believe we can claim that.
I think you can, whether you're a dinghy or a super yacht, whether you're swimming or paddling, Budget Marine has most of the things you need. But Robbie, we didn't start in Antigua and Barbuda. Where did you actually start Budget Marine?
We started in the nearby island of St. Martin. And we have 13 locations spread all over the Eastern Caribbean, and recently soon to start in Colombia.
Well, I know you have a passion for sailing. Did your passion for sailing come first, or Budget Marine come first?
I admit to sailing being the starter.
Now, how is it, if you're a sailor and you enter all the competitions, and you run Budget Marine? Louisa does most of the work, I expect.
Louisa runs Budget Marine and team.
But do you find you have a conflict of interest in just the sailing and the business?
Yes, that's always the case. There are so many conflicts in this business. The conflict we have in the sailing world, we have sailors and we have pirates. We have people who paddle stand-up paddle boards, kayaks. Some people just want barbecues.
And you sell those as well?
Yes, it's a wide range. And we also sell some things that people use in houses, stainless steel bolts, stainless steel hinges. Any contributions here?
Everything. You could even get household items from us, cleaning supplies, everything you could get at Budget Marine. I would like to think when Robbie started in Antigua 30 years ago, he probably was just focusing on what goes underwater. But today, we can proudly say that we have diverted into some areas that is doing very, very well.
That's good to know. And what brought you to Antigua from...
Sorry, just to... it's when something is... goes on a boat, it needs to be anti-corrosive and it needs to be of a particular quality. Everything in that category is what we're trying to do.
So you can't just buy something from a household shop and stick it on a boat?
You can, but it's not a success.
It's not going to last. So what brought you to Antigua and Barbuda? You were going well in St. Martin's?
Well, Antigua has always been the real standout in the Caribbean.
Yes.
And early years, it was the real yachting centers were St. Thomas, Antigua, and St. Martin was just a little peripheral place. So for us, it was we were attracted to the great, to the center of yachting in the Caribbean.
Well, that's good to hear. We are a powerhouse for yachting. Center of excellence, all those good words, but we really are. People come from all over the world. And of course, they know that Budget Marine is going to be there to provide them with what they want. So 30 years, Robbie, what have been some of the highlights of 30 years in Antigua and Barbuda?
It's been a string of positives. I can't claim to have particular moments, but the yachting industry has continued to grow. I think one of the key things that makes Antigua stand out in the Caribbean in respect of yachting is the fact that the population of Antigua are more integrated with the yachting than many other islands.
That's interesting to know, because sometimes you don't get that feeling, but I know that in every country where you have stores, you provide a lot of serious training. Your people need to know a lot about sailing, a lot about everything, but here you find that particularly the love of sailing, the passion of sailing, the understanding of what it means is greater here.
The interest, the drive, and the openness to engage in the challenges of marine equipment is better in Antigua than any other island that I have been involved in. and I speak from the heart, and I do a lot of training, and then not only is that the case, but Louisa has made that happen.
Louisa, you really are a powerhouse behind this, aren't you now? So what, for you, what is the most important thing that you do at Budget Marine at the moment? What is Budget Marine's real key driver, most important thing?
Meeting customers' expectations.
Yeah.
That is the key. We do this in many ways. We conduct training sessions with the staff every summer. It goes from, I think, May until November each year. And that is because we want our staff, our sales floor staff, to be equipped with the knowledge to meet those customers' expectations. There would be times that they would even be challenged. They may just have requests for items that we don't carry, they never heard about. But we still try to meet those expectations of our customers. So that is what drives us. That's the passion behind our success.
And that is something I think customers know. They know that you go in, you ask somebody, if they don't know what you want, they will find out. But they do know what they're talking about.
Most times.
Most times.
But in parallel with that, it's also, Antigua has developed in a number of areas, like in youth development. Antigua is way out in front. In youth competitive sailing, Antigua is way out in front. In terms of the top edge Grand Prix racing, Antigua is maybe not as far, but very, very, very strong and consistent. So a home for a Chandlery in Antigua, Antigua is very suited to that.
Now we have seen in the last few years that youth sailing really, really take off, and we've had championships, we've had people going to the Optimus Championships, we have Janella King sailing around the world with the maiden ladies, and they all started their sailing in Antigua and Barbuda, and of course supported very much by Budget Marine. Now you sponsor the High Tide Series, you also always sponsor the Valentine Regatta at Jolly Harbour, which is here in a couple of weeks, and you've got rather an exciting sponsorship coming up, haven't you, Robbie?
We have a big sponsorship coming up next year, June, and here is Louisa going to tell us about.
Louisa, tell us what's happening in June.
Actually, it's this year, June, Robbie. This year, June, we are very happy and pleased to announce that we are the silver sponsors for the Island Girls, Antigua and Barbuda Island Girls. They will be, for the first time, attempting the Pacific Challenge. And with all the support, we believe they're going to be a winner.
They're going to be amazing. Now, I've spoken to them a few times, especially when they sailed the Atlantic, rode the Atlantic. And I did say to one of them, well, you've done that. Why would you do it again? And they said, well, we didn't do the Pacific.
That's the thing with women.
Wow, they are amazing.
Love challenges.
They are amazing. Great credit to Antigua and a credit to Budget Marine. I think that's such a great sponsorship, Robbie. And
thank you,
Louise. That is so brilliant. And what about the next 30 years? I know that in English Harbour, you definitely extended your shop, doubled in size the last couple of, about 2 years ago, I think. So what's the next 30 years going to bring for you?
I'd invite Robbie to answer that.
Robbie, what are your visions?
Yachting is developing hugely, and as usual, nobody really notices the technology of yachting changing. The boats are doing things. Right now it's a transatlantic race. People are doing crossing the Atlantic.
Well, they're rowing for some obscure reason.
They're also rowing. But people are crossing the Atlantic with average speeds just under 30 knots.
Oh, wow.
So the technology is changing. The important thing is to stick with the change in the industry and the sport. Engines, outboard engines, for instance, huge changes happening. And every area, carbon is replacing fiberglass, it's endless. The next 10 years is all about Antigua keeping that momentum of rolling along with the industry.
And Budget Marine doing so as well. But we've got a lot of new technology. Now, how is that changing the face of sailing, especially in Antigua?
It's becoming more complicated.
Yeah.
And it's becoming people need to step up to the plate to understand what the new yachts do that the old ones didn't, and to fix them.
And yeah, well, we're going to see something in Antigua Sailing Week this year, something new and dramatic. We have a foiling, we're going to have a foiling race. Now, this is something we've seen in the America's Cup, but it's quite new for us here in Antigua and Barbuda to have a foiling class in the regatta. Is that something you're looking forward to?
Yes, we actually had the Falconis, they actually had a foiling catamaran here already, so we have some Antiguans who are already up at the top end of that game. But we're going to see foiling, and yes, we've got to adapt to foiling. And we're probably going to have to fix foils.
You will have to fix foils. I take it for granted, I'm not even asking, but you have all the things you need for foiling here in Budget Marine.
If we don't have it yet, we will get it.
And just so that people know,
we will stock what sailors want.
There you go. We will stock what sailors want. Make sure they do. Hold them to it. But just so that people know, we're here in Jolly Harbour. We're celebrating today in Jolly Harbour. But Budget Marine is also in English Harbour. Even more boats down there in English Harbour. And more of the super yachts. But you're also in North Sound as well. Is that right?
That's correct. We're at North Sound. Formerly Stanford Marina, those persons who are not familiar. And we've been there now for 7 years. 7 years growing with that marina.
And although Antigua is small, even 7 miles seems an awfully long way to us because we're not used to traveling that far. So it's great that people in North Sound or English Harbour or here in Jolly Harbour don't have to go that vast mileage to anywhere else. It's great that they can just wander up there and get it.
They certainly don't, and we have this relationship with our customers that if there's an item they require and it's at a North Sound branch, we'll get it to them the next day. Same for English Harbour. We're not advertising that we have a delivery service, but we have the relationship among ourselves as staff to meet the customer's expectations. I want to use that tagline because most of what we do is to satisfy our customers, make them happy so that they can keep returning to us.
And they do keep returning. Now, you and I were chatting earlier on as well, and we were talking about some of your customers who have been loyal for, 30 years. And you're doing something special for your loyal customers as well, aren't you, this year?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. All our loyal customers, they will be placed on the Budget Marine Loyal Price List. That's offering discounts ranging from 5 to 15%. And in some cases, just talk to the manager, you'll get some more. So that is what we're doing for our customers.
That is fantastic. Now, people do say that the best 2 days in your life are the day you buy a boat and the day you sell it. But Budget Marine is actually making that task a little bit easier, isn't it? Especially with these discounts.
Oh, certainly, certainly. I can tell you some customers wish they didn't have a boat. We see them maybe in an 8-hour day. They're in our shops about 8 to 10 times.
I know somebody like that.
Yeah, they come all the time. And that's what made them special to us. That they know they can come to us to get from a fastener to fix that boat or any decking to repair their decks or just to get a plug because they may have suddenly gotten a hole in the hull. You know, we're there, we have everything. And why we have everything? Because we learn from our customers. Most clients, we learn from them. They come and they tell us what they need. And if we don't have it, we get it.
And that is what people really do need. Now, Robbie has talked about the future technology, the future of technology in sailing, the future of technology for Budget Marine. What about you, Louisa, as the powerhouse behind this? Would you like to see in the next few years for Budget Marine?
Well, certainly technology plays a very, very important part. So we want to attract the right staff who embraces that technology. Also participate in those training sessions that we have so we can offer the customer the service that they are looking for. So it's all about us being abreast with what's happening out there with regards to technology. But we know that is the way, that is the path. And we are definitely on board where that is concerned.
Excellent. One quick question before you go back to Robbie though, Louisa. Do you sail?
I am planning to.
I'm planning to?
I'm yet to gather that confidence that when I go there and I see waves 10 feet, 12 feet, that I am safe. Especially with the with those items at Virgin Marine, because we have fantastic safety gear. We have the inflatable life jacket that you could just put a button and it comes on, a light that comes on. So I should feel safe, but I need to have the courage to face those waves, and that's what's keeping me back. But who knows?
It's quite a tough one, actually. But there's a challenge for Robbie and for you.
I don't think a challenge for him. He loves sailing.
I know Robbie does, but to get you on the water.
Let me talk a bit about technology.
Yes, please.
We have 13 locations, and they're in different jurisdictions. Every customer can go on our website and see what of any particular item that has a photo on the website, and we're talking 16,000 items, every customer can see on the website what we've got in stock, what the item looks like, and the price in the currency of that location.
So if we couldn't find something, we could look at the website in St. Martin's.
Yeah, and if you were sailing to Grenada, or let's say Trinidad, where they have TT dollars, you could find out exactly that when you get to Trinidad, whether the product is likely to be in stock, at what price, and how many there are.
That is something you really need to know. Robbie, when you started this 30 years ago in Antigua, and many more years there, did you ever see yourself or think that you would have this many budget marine around the Caribbean, and it would be the biggest charter in the Caribbean?
No, but when I realized the technology that was, because the problem is managing those products.
Yeah.
And as we went along and we realized what technology could do to assist, to make it possible to manage that many different products, because there's a difference between chandlery products and food products, because everybody knows what a food product looks like.
Yeah.
You know what a sausage looks like and a loaf of bread, but not everybody knows what some things on boats look like. So you need a lot of technology. As we went along, we realized that you could get that technology. We have bought that technology, and it's working beautifully.
Yeah, that is true. I have my own experience. I was told this morning, make sure you get there early and get some lugs. What? But I said, I need lugs. But your guys knew exactly what I was talking about. I had no idea what I was looking for. I couldn't even look around the shop. I just said, lugs, there they are in my bag. Your staff really know, because you're right, we have no idea what bits and pieces look like unless you're an engineer or a boat potterer. So that is a really good point. So I hope you're not going to wait another 30 years before you celebrate. So another 10 years, we'll be having another 40-year celebration?
No, I think maybe every 5 years. I think it's important for us to reach out to our customers, engage, demonstrate our appreciation for their loyalty. And waiting 30 years to do that, no. I would like to suggest every 5 years is sufficient.
I think that's fantastic. And Budget Marine really is the place to go. And you've heard it here. What they care about most is the customers. They use technology for you to get exactly what you want. They give customer service, the staff are trained. And you can hear the passion in both Robbie and Louisa. Robbie and Louisa, thank you so much for joining me this afternoon.
Thank you, Zoe.
Thank you, Zoe.
Let's go and party. Party with us in Jolly Harbour Budget Marine.